Hello, this is a how to play Christmas Tree the Decorating. Christmas Tree is a two-player game, although if you have multiple copies of the game, you can expand it to three or four players. But in this is the two-player version. In the two-player version, there are 12 cards plus two scoring cards. The scoring cards you can see over here. Just keep track. You just use a token and just keep track of what your current score is. The other 12 cards are just randomized, and then six cards are dealt to each of the two players. The cards contain an ornament in the center of them. They are double-sided cards and light bulbs around the edges, and then you can also see the wires, which help identify the connections for the two bulb clusters and the three bulb clusters. Essentially, what's going to happen is over the course of the game, the players are going to build a Christmas tree because they're each playing one card per turn. And as you can see, the Christmas tree will ultimately be formed of a total of 10 cards in this pattern, where there's a row of four cards on the bottom. Then three, then two, and then one. Now it only takes 10 cards to complete the tree, but each player has six cards, so they're going to have one left over, and they're going to play their final card on top of any of the other cards, and that's going to be their chance to score the most amount of points with their last card played. But essentially, the game ends. Whoever has that when the player's last card is played, whoever has the highest amount of points is the winner. And I think I already said who the first player to go is whoever's birthday is closest to Christmas. Each player is going to play one card per turn. The orientation of the tree is not predetermined, so it's not always going in the same direction. It's just when you're playing your card, it has to be adjacent to an existing card that's already on the board. And in terms of scoring points, when you play a card, there's basically two ways to get points. There are the adjacent matching ornaments. You can see in the center of the cards, there are stars, candy canes, snowmen, and gingerbread men. And if you were to play, let's say I played this card right here, which has a star, in order to score the adjacent matching ornament points, however many cards that are next to it that share the same ornament are going to be worth 1 point, plus the one that I played. So that'll be worth 2 points if I played this card right here. Okay, just for the ornament piece portion of it, but then I would also get to get points for any two bulb or three bulb clusters that are matching, and so I would then look for all of the connections around the card that I played. And in this case, there are no connection here. Here, there are three bulbs of different colors, so that three bulb cluster is worth 0 points. Here, there's a two bulb cluster, and they each share the same color, blue. So that's going to be worth 2 points for me. There are no matching light bulbs for that three bulb cluster, and none for this one as well. So if I played this card here, it would be worth a total of 4 points, two for the adjacent matching ornaments, one and two, and then two for the two bulb cluster. That's essentially how you get points. Remember, on your first card played, each player is going to get no points for their first card, but your second through the sixth, you're going to score points normally. Your last card, you're going to get the most amount of points possible, hopefully. And a little bit of a strategy: when you're playing your cards, you want to obviously try to get the most amount of points, but you also don't want to set up your opponent for being able to get more points than your last play is kind of something you want to keep in mind. That's Christmas Tree. If you have any questions, go over to the Facebook page or group, and ask away, and I'll answer. All right, thank you. Bye-bye.